Everyone, welcome back to the channel. What we're going to be doing today is we're continuing on the restoration of this number one Pettingell power hammer. What's on tap for today is to connect these arms here from the main mast to the arms of the hammer itself to give it some more support. What I came up with here for the supports is some 1-inch DOM 120 wall material that I added some threaded, well actually it's bolt that I cut down to put in the end of the piece of tubing. And one side is going to be actually welded to a plate that's going to go on the arm, and the other side here with the threads with the nuts and washers will end up going to the arms itself on the main mast, and then they can be tightened and loosened to give the arms the location that they need to be for the best die contact. Here are the pieces for the upper mounts of the arm, and what I did was I added this material here on both sides so that I can actually put the way the mast is built, that where it supports the motor up top, I'm thinking about possibly running another brace down from the top to help support also in that regard. A bit of triangulation to see how that can go. What I took was a piece of 5/8 rod, threaded both ends, and this is long enough to go through with the arm in the center to then tighten up and have the arms come in and be welded to the sides of the plate. rods to the main arms of the mast. What I ended up doing was taking some angle iron and cut it so that it matched the angle of the strut rod going out to the arm of the hammer, and then with nuts and washers on both sides of the angle iron, I'm able to tighten and loosen each side so that I can get the arm exactly where I need it to be. Well, that's going to about wrap it up for this video for today. The arms came out pretty good where I want them to be, and they look like they're going to be plenty sturdy enough to do what I need them to do. The next thing that we're going to be messing with is the hydraulic system for the hammer that actuates the hammer. So I'll be disassembling and cleaning up the master cylinder and the slave cylinder that operate the hammer. So thanks a lot for watching. Please like, subscribe, and if you have any comments, please leave them down below. And until next time, have at it.